Hi, I'm Bihar Chatterjee, presently the Special Public Prosecutor for the Government of West Bengal for cyber crime and electronic evidence related cases. I've done my LLM and a lot of certifications from different part of the world on blockchain and all these AI, artificial intelligence and all these related fields. And we all aware of this today, this is the era of ABCD. A for artificial intelligence, B for blockchain, C for cloud, and D for data. Now in the area of the big data. So these are all technical things that are more and more affecting our judiciaries, our the way appreciation of evidences. Because see, in India, there are India is now second largest internet user. We got it from different sources. But the people around in India are using WhatsApp, Facebook, and a lot of online sites and all these e-commerce sites for their everyday applications, buying and selling and all these issues. So a lot of evidences are been there in the electronic evidence, in the virtual world and all this. And those electronic evidences have been collected and put forward in proper way, in admissible way. First, the thing is that the evidence has to be relevant, and then evidence has to be admissible. And if we can make those and present those cases before the court on behalf of prosecution, or even on behalf of our client, on behalf of defense, and all this, in case of civil suit as well, there can be a fantastic way to appreciate the real evidence, and the court can reach to the correct findings. So for proper adjudications, electronic evidence is a very important role to play, and it is going to play a role very crucial in the days to come, because without electronic evidence might not be that evidence at the entire process of getting entire investigations or putting the entire data coming from the investigation into trial, and all this will not be completed. So we are in the era of modern ages, and all these ages and all these things have been applicable to those things, and evidences are throughout the, it's not that issue that the taking of electronic evidences and putting that electronic evidence admissible in the court of law is a challenge in India alone. It's a global issue, and the biggest problem is that the electronic evidence is very susceptible to change, is very prone to change, is very sensitive, and that's why how to collect, how to preserve, and how to present that evidence before the court of law is the most crucial thing. And there are a lot of problems for my legal brothers who are actually practicing and who are going to start or who are doing pursuing their LLB and LLM degrees and all this, and even in case of judiciaries and all this, how to appreciate the evidences in the days to come. So I should myself call as a techno-legal person, because a lot of upgradations I have to regularly been made to myself. A lot of certifications, a lot of new adopting with the new technologies changes. Because if you take the Section 4 of Information Technology Act, and also the Section 3, the definitions of evidence itself in an evidence act, so you'll see that the applicability of electronic evidences maybe in many many ways, and there is no limit to that effect. Nothing could say that if the evidence is in an E form or in this form, the court is not going to accept it as per the mandate of Section 4. So we have to be ready for the welcoming of electronic evidences. And that's why I thought when I'm presently conducting a lot of cases on behalf of the state of West Bengal on all this, and the state of West Bengal has got the dedicated special public prosecutor for cybercrime and electronic evidences. I do interact with judges and police officers in different academies, and discuss my cases. It's a good news that in Bengal there are back-to-back consecutive five convictions from 2016 till date on cases which are connected and directly connected with Electronic Evidence and Information Technology Act. And in all those cases, I'm very hopeful and very privileged that I have been the special public prosecutor conducting the cases on behalf of the state. And we learn a lot, and there are a lot of applications being made, starting from Google Map, Lat Long, and a lot of evidences in my later video. That's why I thought there should have been a video by which YouTube channel by which we can, there will be a lot of videos, and there, by this channel I can share my experiences which I have in my day-to-day life, and I'm going to have in my day-to-day lives in my all practical cases which I am now conducting on behalf of the state of West Bengal, though the matter is all sub judice and I cannot discuss on this, but those cases which have actually been settled, the judgment is passed, and in those cases I can give you some details of the hints of which we should share, because this video or this channel and the series of videos being uploaded in this channel will be only for the purpose to the students of law, because we all are students of law, and also for the common people, and even for the student, for the people who are dealing with the technology, especially in the IT field and all this. Say for example, if a fire tender doesn't know how to deal with the fire, how can he save himself or herself from the menace of fire? So that is also another important thing, and in the days to come I must discuss with the different issues of different types of cybercrime cases. Say for example, when I first wrote my book Cybercrime Manual, I have encountered some of the cases which is actually mind-boggling. Say for example, brain hacking, is it at all possible? And if it is not been possible at all, maybe a fiction story and all this, but one thing is definitely there, that there is a concept called cyber psycho torture. Means it's a different field of cyber, different accounts, different applications, different things can be used for the purpose of disturbing a people mentally, and even to take him or her to that level. Recently I got a case in some of the lady visited my chamber with an allegations that in our house, whatever she was doing, actually everything was being recorded, and someone was there who was actually recording everything, even when she is changing her dresses and all this, and those things are actually on the second moment that there is a YouTube videos been coming up, and those videos are actually concerning about those things which he is actually doing or thinking or telling or listening and working. So these type of things are happening and happening every day, and these cases are now getting more and more. So this is, I think this is one of the darkest crime in the world, to when a people's brain been disturbed, they'll be tortured psychologically by the use of this cyber world and all this. There are good things around. There are a lot of applications. Life has become very smooth with the applications of this internet and all this, and the way it's making the life more smoother, smoother and smooth, making life more smooth. And the same way, the crime is coming up in different form, different things. The people the people who are sitting in the room with a malified motive and thinking of siphoning your money, taking your money from that account by debit card, hacking credit card, and what are different crimes are there, economic crimes, because see, there the majority of the economic transactions in the world today are being done through virtual world. So in my coming videos, I'm going to discuss about whatever the traceability path, and what is the crux of electronic evidences, how the investigation to be done in case of an complaint being filed, in case of hacking a Facebook or even running a fake Facebook profile, and all these different cases, say starting from ATM hacking and all this. So that is going to help.